What's up? Let's go with episode 36, and you might be like me, struggling in this weird market. What do I buy now? So let's get into this. Let's have some fun. Welcome to... Episode 36 of Mealy Stocks. How you doing? Hopefully you've been doing well. Welcome to a safe haven as we navigate a very different time in the sports card market, the collectible market in general. So my name is Jamil. I'm part of the Mealy Stocks team. I am the Mealy Stocks team, I guess. And we're part of the Slab Stocks Network, as you know. Card shop owner here in Gainesville, Florida. So let me show you a couple things going on with our shop, and then we are going to get into a fun episode, I think, with episode 36 this week. I wanted to share with you next Tuesday. I don't know if we'll have an episode up by then, but we're going to have another version of what we call Mealy Pops Chats, and I'll be chatting with Ryan, Card Collector 2, Ryan Johnson. He's many of you guys know him. He's done an incredible job with his new shop. And he and I have both opened shops really in the last couple years. So we said, why don't we kind of answer this question we get a lot of time. How do you open a shop? What's it like? Have some question and answering. Give away some stuff. So this will be 9 p.m. on Instagram Live on Tuesday, June 15th. So come on out. Hang out with us June 15th. Be really cool to see you. All right. So let's get into it. You might be like many right now, thinking, what's going on? And if you watched episode 35, I talked a little bit about the market correction, the shifts that I'm noticing in the shop. And I think it's a good time to maybe reflect and really consider what is going on. How do I buy? How do I sell? How do I collect? And then maybe make some adjustments from that point on. I've had this question a lot now, and people now saying to me, well, how do I make money? How do I buy and flip? How do I know where to go? What should I buy? And I think it's a valid point with some concern because you just don't know right now. The markets seem to just continually be dropping on a lot of things. Even if you bought something at a 10 or 20% markdown, in a week or two, if you haven't resold it, you might only be breaking even or losing money. So I get it. But I wanted to talk about some key points that I've been kind of reflecting back on and I think will maybe help you. So the first thing is, if you're looking to buy stuff and you're looking to get into, buying cards, flipping cards, grading cards, whatever, I would consider upside markets. And what I mean by that is markets that may not be as traditional as you think, markets that have a lot of upside, whether it be to demand, whether it be to scarcity, whether it be to opportunity. And I'll touch on each one of those. So for me, like soccer, here's a good example, right? European soccer is not going to go down, soccer cards, in the next probably couple weeks unless somebody just completely falls flat on their face or whatnot because of the Euro tournament, right? So we're going to see much more focus, attention on the European 2021 tournament, which was supposed to be, of course, 2020. And then additionally to soccer, soccer wax, soccer singles, soccer in general, you have the qualifiers for the World Cup 2022 in Qatar. So as we move towards that, I think that soccer is actually a pretty safe haven for a lot of people. Now, a lot of you may be thinking only the uber high-end, Haaland, and so on and so forth. Be very careful in that because with Mr. Erling, he may not be relevant unless he gets traded, moves from Dortmund, simply because he's not qualifying for the Euros, and he's probably not going to make the World Cup with his national team. And then if he stays on Dortmund, maybe there'll be a little lull in his card prices before he may move to like a Real or somewhere else. So I encourage you to consider like that emerging market of soccer. I do think there's a lot of play there. I think there's a lot of things that you can make money on. I think there's a lot of room for grading, low population reports. So a market that is upside is soccer to me. So one thing maybe you might be considered buying. Another thing is low production items. What I mean by that is F1 Formula 1 Chrome, Formula 1 Dynasty. If you go back and look at those products and you look at what's coming out soon, which is Formula 1 Tops like the paper, which I know also will be low production, those are some products that you're not seeing a lot of. And there's not really a lot of people in the domestic stateside buying a lot of it, but you are seeing a huge amount of people buying it internationally. Again, UFC. We will have a UFC Select that will come out eventually, but UFC Prizm cards. I do think it's interesting to watch some of the really high-end golds and blacks and mojos, the low-numbered stuff. You're not seeing a lot of that pop up. So, you know, seeking this stuff out, maybe buying some fighters that you might want to prospect on. It seems like every way, shape, and form, our culture in America is so focused on these celebrity fights, right, with Mayweather and Logan Paul. Shout out Charles RBGS10 on the chain. But as we consider these things, I would encourage you to think about those markets that there may not be a lot of those products out. And with UFC and F1, you have an opportunity to buy some of the stuff that you've never seen before, in terms of, you know, cards produced by Topps, cards produced by Panini with the Prizm brand, that I think might have, you know, a good longevity to them. And then lastly, something that I really enjoy, and I think a lot of you out there probably enjoy, is actually looking at cards that have a cultural or a media basis, specifically in Marvel and Star Wars cards. And what I bring up those is because if you think about the heightened anticipation of things like Loki, which releases this week, and the Disney Plus series, Falcon and the Winter Soldier, Scarlet Witch with WandaVision, the Marvel world, the cards, the PMGs of the old Ultras and Retro series, the reds and the greens and the blues and the golds and all that stuff, super sought after, very valuable, high-grade stuff, sells for a lot of money. Additionally, the one-of-one sketch cards, another market that there's very there's a huge amount of limitations to, where if you go out there and look and find some cool sketches, I think they can sell for a lot more than you'd realize. So you have to kind of pay attention to what is going on, the upside markets that I mentioned, and taking that opportunity, right, and looking at upside, being very careful in blue chip cards. And what I mean by that is, this is a rule that I think so many people have been so focused on for the last, you know, centuries, really sports cards, is buying blue chip because they'll always go up. Well, wait a second. What about LeBron James? You know, what about Kevin Durant? What about Mike Trout? Let's talk about those things for a second. Kevin Durant looks awesome. The Nets look incredible. His chrome refractor is going down. LeBron James, if you had bought one of his PSA 10 chrome refractors, Aaron did a good job, and Nate and the Slap Sox guys with putting together that graph, 151 or whatever, and the last one selling for $91,000. Something to think about. So I think the rules regarding blue chip kind of players and all that, yeah, sure, the long term, I think that there's a play there, and I think you can always make money with it. But with the short term and looking to buy and sell, be very careful with these blue chip cards, because I think there is so much anticipation and money, not anticipation, but so much focus and money pumped into those kinds of cards that a lot of people are now backing out of some of those and looking for different flips. Look at the Luka Prizm 10. Many people thought that card would have gone to 1200, 1300, 1400 when it's down to 700-800 now, right? So being mindful of these things, watching trends, and not always basing it on years past or the previous histories that we've had, I think will help you tremendously navigating this world. If you're looking for the long term, I would probably say it's not a bad buy to buy those names. But for the short term, or for maybe even like the 4 to 8 month term, right, that to me is not as short term as maybe a month or two. I would be very mindful of looking at blue chip, because I feel like on some cards, we've had some drops and corrections right in the market. But even someone like LeBron, who maybe hasn't gained a lot of fans, he's lost some fans, maybe his stuff will drop even farther before it kind of corrects. But just time will tell. We'll see it, right? I think football is an interesting play, right? I think there's a lot of things going on with football. You have hockey as well, baseball, all these other elements going on. But just kind of be mindful of that. Hear what I'm saying on that, please, people. I'm not telling you not to buy blue chip cards, but I'm saying pay attention to the trends, because the trends are a little different than they've ever been before. And then lastly, if there's something you're looking to buy in this kind of wild market, I would consider other collectibles, right? I mean, you like cards, you like what they're about, you like the graded element, you like the pulls. Maybe shift a little bit. Maybe put some money in some investment, or just have some fun buying some comics that are graded. Maybe have some fun, with a graded video game, WADA, right? look at some of the upcoming movies or titles or things, as I brought up comics, and maybe try your hand in that. See what happens with, you know, some Carnage first appearances or Venom first appearances or Spider-Man. You know, if you really, for you big high-end collectors, with all of that kind of becoming a central theme for Marvel in 2021. I do think some of that stuff can gauge you and can make you think a little differently about how you look at cards, specifically when you start bleeding into other collectible markets. And then lastly, you know, a big thing for us in the shop is we're going to be looking to carry more Dragon Ball Z, some Digimon alongside the Pokemon that we carry in Yu-Gi-Oh! Just mainly because I do think that there's some emergent markets forming with Dragon Ball Z and Yu-Gi-Oh!, even Digimon, with these deck playing cards, but there's a collectability factor with grading and people, you know, looking for the uber rares, the ultra rares, the secret rares, the all that kind of stuff that I think plays into a separate market. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, do your research, look at it, take some time looking at this stuff. I think it'll be interesting to see how they pan out over these next 6 to 12 months. And then just lastly, you know, as we are a card shop, I do want to bring up some releases this week. We have SP Game Used Golf, another interesting kind of product. Only the second release of Golf by Upper Deck in a long, long time, right? We had Artifacts before. And then additionally, we have on Friday two big releases in Champions League Chrome Soccer, Topps Chrome, which is, I think, going to be a very big release. The checklist looks very promising. And, of course, like I said, it's going to play right in hand with the Euro tournaments, as well as World Cup qualifying moving forward, more so the Euro tournaments. And, of course, a big release for us down here in the Southeast and football country is 2021 Prism Draft Football, which to me has overtaken Contenders in terms of the collectability. It came out, 2 years ago? And taking over the collectability, taking over some of the focus on the early season in collecting these really awesome looking Prism cards. And I believe they have something, I didn't do my research as well, it's not called Downtown, I think it's called Campus or Campus Cards or something like that. For me in Gainesville, we have a version of Pitts, Kyle Pitts, we have a version of Kyle Trask, we have color rushes of those guys. How cool is it going to be to kind of see that college football vibe in 2021 football? I think Prism is going to be a strong product. They also have their hybrid versions and, of course, I'm sure retail options coming out. But a lot of fun things going on in the card world. I call this the most interesting time because the last year, year and a half, it's just been like this and it's just been so easy. Now it gets hard. Now it's when the rubber meets the road and this is when you really got to pay attention and focus. I'm not a doom and gloom guy and a lot of you might be like, man, that's because you're on a card shop. And that's not the truth. I'm not a doom and gloom guy because I know this hobby. I've been around it for a long time, right? And I've watched it. I've been a part of it as a customer, a collector, a dealer, just as someone who observes. And I do think we're seeing a correction from the last year and a half and the boom. What will happen? When will it kind of come back up? I don't know. Are we in the dip, so buy the dip? Or are we in the semi-dip, so wait a little bit before we get to the real dip? Don't know. Only time will tell. So just be mindful of those things. And I said it last week, and I say it again. Make your own decisions. You know what I mean? Some of the loudest voices in this hobby and the things that we see and watch sometimes are the worst advice. And I see that, and I listen to it sometimes. And I'm not pointing fingers at anybody like that. I think it's important for us to really care about how we spend our money, how we engage in this hobby, and to make sure we're doing it for ourselves, not because someone told me to do it. You know what I mean? But I'm really excited, looking forward to seeing the Slab Stocks platform come out. I know this is something that Aaron's been working on a long time, and just really excited to see just the card market in general. I will have some exciting news coming up, something I've been working on as well. But until we get to that in episode 37, keep having fun in the hobby.